Hello, I'm StivityBobo. This is Banjo-Kazooie 100%. 100% is defined as collecting all 100 jiggies, 900 notes, and 24 extra honeycomb pieces. Right now, I'm going to be setting up a glitch before I start the run. So this glitch is going to allow me to use moves from a different file on my new file. And what I do is I game over on a Furnace Fun minigame. And this... It's complicated to explain, but... what it is so when I enter Furnace Fun, the game creates a temporary memory address for my move value, and so the game doesn't want me to use my moves on the board, the Furnace Fun board, so it creates a temporary memory address for my moves and moves it to that address while I'm on the board. So what I do is I go to a mini game in Furnace Fun and I game over in it, and this allows me to when I go to a new file, the game will still have the move value in that temporary memory address. And so when I start a new file and go into a loading zone in the lair, it'll give me back that value from the memory address. It's hard to explain. I'm not doing a good job explaining it, so I'll just stop there. Anyway. Just gonna game over here. Alright, I'm gonna start now. So 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, go. Okay. Sparrow Mountain is pretty straightforward. You just have to collect 6 empty honeycomb pieces and get into the lair. That first jump is pretty finicky. I'm lucky to have gotten it on the first try. And that cauliflower that I just killed is completely RNG. It wasn't in a terrible spot, so that was pretty good. So this jump right here, I can actually land on a little sliver of the platform there and jump over the bottle's trigger. It saves a few seconds.
No.
Just looking to see who you are, that's all. No, that's cool. Alright, so as you can see, I'm using Talon Trot right away. You're supposed to learn it in the level, but since I activated that glitch that I was trying to explain but didn't do a very good job at doing, I'm using it now. Okay, so that section right there, you're supposed to do as a termite. You're supposed to turn into a termite by visiting Mumbo and paying 5 Mumbo tokens. But I abused a mechanic of the game. You can stay on slopes longer. You can stay on slopes for about a second. So if you move your shadow onto flat ground, that resets the slope timer. So what you can do is keep jumping on and off a slope and you won't slide down. So basically, I'm just abusing that mechanic. Something went wrong. This isn't right. Something went wrong. So I'm not supposed to have learned the eggs on my setup file, and for some reason I have it learned, and that just set me back about 50 eggs, which is going to be extremely bad. I don't know why that happened. I must have accidentally learned the eggs on my setup file. Yeah, I'm not sure how this is going to pan out now. That was completely my fault. Not quite sure what to do. So, this is unfortunate, but I'm gonna have to just get a bunch of eggs throughout the run now. To make up for that.
I have a dollar donation from Stiv's biggest fan. Hey Stiv, good luck on this run. You may not have anyone to catch with you during this run, but Chad and I are with you. Much love.
Thank you very much.
Oh.
What I tried to do there was grab the jiggy and land in the water so I could skip this dance animation, which is about 8 seconds. It's a little longer if you're getting the last jiggy, so it's not too big of a deal, but... Right there, I also abused the slope timer to get that jiggy. You're supposed to get that with the termite, but you don't have to. So I'm not supposed to be able to get to this portrait right away, but again, the glitch that I activated before the run allows me to have that move because I had it in the other file. Treasure Trove Cove is a pretty hard level. There's a lot of flying tech that you have to pull off. And it takes a while to get used to for newer runners, but you do it so much that you get used to it quickly. So again, I'm gonna have to look for some spare eggs because I'm at a really big deficit right now. Flying and get free 25 feathers, supposed to be the case with eggs, but I screwed up. So, this right here is RNG. You want Blubber to be in a position such that the jiggy lands on top of you. If you're not in that position, then you waste 4 seconds or so for Blubber to go away. Right now, it's basically just all movement. nothing too crazy going on right now. So you want to pick up jiggies in swimming or flight or anything other than just walking into it as much as possible so you can skip that dance animation, because it's 5 seconds every time and about 8 seconds on the last jiggy of the level. So that technique right there that I did is called quick diving. If you enter the water while Banjo is in the middle of an animation, it cancels out the entering water animation, so Banjo just sinks down. That right there was the Nipper quick kill. It's not the intended way of killing him, but yeah. Ooh. Okay, I was gonna try to be safe there, but I guess I didn't need to. That looked a little off to me, but it worked. So I set up my angle so that I could just poop two eggs into the bucket below. Okay, right, this is some pretty hard flying technique right here. I might have missed the notes. No, I'm good. Okay, I'm gonna kill this crab here because he is very dangerous. And I need health. And I need that X. I don't know why I'm not getting it. Banjo-Kazooie. Pretty straightforward. What I did there was I grabbed the jiggy and then I died on top of the crab. So I still got the jiggy, but I skipped the animation. And then I death warped to the beginning of the level. Alright, not terrible, but again, I'm still low on eggs, so I'm kind of worried about that. never really thought of what to do in case that happens. So I'm activating this cauldron for later. See him later on. So Clanker's Cavern is a very cycle-based level. Most of the time you're just racing against the clock to make some cycles to save like 10 seconds or so. It's pretty tight. Yeah, I'm not surprised. So I missed that jump there, and that's gonna make me miss a cycle or so. So that's not how I normally do that area, but that's the backup way in case you miss the jump like I did. Next section is pretty tight. I need to do this. I need to execute this well in order to make the blowhole cycle later on.
Oh.
jump is actually really hard to do. But luckily I got it. Oh, that's a magic. Okay, so I made it. That was actually very good. Actually very easy to dodge. There's a chance you can get hit by them if you're jutting out to get the notes, but if you just stick to the side like this, they won't hit you. Not sure why, it's just how it's programmed. There to get down a little quicker. Honestly, probably shouldn't have used eggs at all there. So now this section here, I'm going to be timing it so that I die right when I get the last item of the level, such that I death warp and I can weave really quickly. It looks really tight, and it is, but it works out all the time. Unless I miss an item, that would be really bad. Yeah. Yay, more eggs. It's faster to open Freezies and Pete before you enter Bubble Loop Swamp. It's actually faster to skip opening Freezies and Pete altogether, but I won't get into that. Bubble Gloop Swamp is a very RNG-heavy level, and it's very inconsistent, so it's frustrating when you're going for PB attempts. Break them to reveal a jump pad that you can use, but you actually don't have to do that. This hut specifically, it's really hard to make the jump, so I don't do it. That's not gonna hit. That'll hit. Okay, so I was trying to hit the witch switch and activate that croc at the same time, which would skip one cutscene, but I wasn't confident in that shot. It's probably better off, honestly. Should be good on eggs soon, honestly. I've been getting quite a lot. That dragonfly, he's kind of a pain. Get these two, why not? Oh, whatever, I missed one. So this is kind of a memory minigame. I usually write down the answers as I go along. So hopefully I can remember them. That was bad RNG. You want to get turtles that are adjacent to each other, because obviously it's quicker. RNG wasn't terrible, and thankfully I remembered the pattern. Should be good on eggs, so I'm not gonna bother with those. I need 6 HP for this next part. Faster to knock out these boots and to just kind of take damage. Okay, more eggs. Not an ideal spot, though. Yeah, I'm good on eggs now. I think I've made up for the loss. I usually have about 40 here, so I won't worry anymore about that. Oh, right, I talked to Mumbo in the first level. There's usually two text boxes there, but I triggered one in the first level. Alright, so this is a mini game. I can't bypass it. I have to spend about 3 minutes on it. Basically, just need to eat more dumplings than Mr. Vile. But what I'm gonna do is just grab some stray items while he gets a lead. And then catch up later on because he slows down. So I'm able to use the running shoes because of that glitch that I was talking about earlier. You're not supposed to have the running shoes here because you learned them in Gobi's Valley, but luckily you can use them. It makes this significantly easier. There's three rounds. Second round, yellow guys start coming up. They're called grumblies, and you're not supposed to eat them. If you do, you get stalled for like a couple seconds. Oh, I ran out of shoes. I have to refill that. Now in the third round, every 10 seconds, the icon at the top switches, indicating which one you're supposed to hit. Look. Well, that's not good. You don't want him to be back here, because that's just more distance you have to travel. But it's okay. Woo! So I want to lure this dragonfly over. Die on him when I have everything. This is not the intended way of doing this, but it's possible. This guy is right in my way. Activating this now, I'm gonna use it later. Gobi's Valley is the next destination. Gobi's Valley is probably one of the hardest levels to do consistently. There's a clip right at the beginning of the level that is very inconsistent and is often a run killer. Hopefully I can get it. If I don't, I'll just have to do the intended way. Wastes about 45 seconds, but it's better than dying. Alright, so this is the clip I was talking about. Right after I get these notes, I'm going to attempt it. First try. That is very good. That never happens. Thank you. Okay, so right here I'm manipulating the camera so that the ring doesn't spawn right away. That, like, makes it possible for me to climb on top of it as it's rising. So this is just a little memory matching game. It's the same every time, so... to grab that with running shoes. That's the intended way, but it's not the only way. So I'm supposed to retain flight, but unfortunately I lost it. Feathers. I don't want to mess with items. So this ring spawns in the same spot every time you leave a loading zone, so we kind of take advantage of that with the routing.
Do we have time for a couple donations?
Yeah, go ahead.
We have $44 from Sour Spinach, no comment. And $10 from DJ Dickdown. This better be read. Stiv, you're doing well with no couch. Hope this donation helps keep you focused.
Thank you. Okay, so that was actually optimal. You want to grab that Jiggy while still in flight.
Thank you.
Normally I skip the eggs, but... yeah. I won't get that one. It's too slow. Not sure how much health I have. I want to have 4, but... I can deal with 3. And as long as my health isn't showing on the screen, then I have at least 3, so... So that was a one-frame jump. If you do a one-frame jump, then the game doesn't register you as having landed on the ground. So the game thought I was still in the air, therefore I took fall damage. So now I have 2 health, so I'll have to get some. So you're supposed to just jump across this maze, but I'll just do the backup strat. Close enough. That thing is closing an opening. So this is why I want health, because I want to get these notes, and then death orb, because I need to have at least 4 HP to get them all, without having to use gold feathers. That's the end of that. Not terrible. I got first try Globy Clip, which is really good. I've had worse. So there's a bit of downtime here, if you want to read any donations.
Well, currently there are no donations, but I believe it is time to plug a sponsor. Today we'll be talking about Tempo Storm. Tempo Storm is a professional gaming organization with teams in Hearthstone, Overwatch, World of Warcraft, Heroes of the Storm, FIFA, and the FGC. But you may be familiar with Tempo Storm for sponsoring STJ and Axe. If you'd like to purchase an STJ or Axe jersey or any Tempo Storm swag, head on over to templestorm.com/store for more info.
So in that instance, quick diving was actually very useful. Swimming is pretty slow, so if you can use it and avoid swimming, then that's a very good thing. So yeah, this part of the game is really boring, but it's necessary, unfortunately. Bad Monster Mansion is a very movement-intensive level. Not too many glitches. Trying to grab that jiggy and go on the flight pad at the same time, which would skip the jiggy dance. But it's kind of hard to do, and I failed it, but it's okay. Just Stiv.
Do we have time for a couple donations?
Yeah, sure.
We have $2 from Esperama. Yo, Stiv, good luck, have fun, and don't forget to do Yorb Stiv.
Thanks, Esper.
And we have $20 from Big John. Well, since there are no donations, there's now a donation. Good luck to all my fellow Speedfasters. Would you like an egg roll?
Thank you, Big John. So this is just another spell, the title of a game, puzzle. I don't know if this game likes to utilize those. Doing this optimally is actually pretty tricky though. Best you can get is 50 seconds on the timer. And I got 49. Pretty much average. And I'm going the wrong way. Whoops. I was doing a lot of any percent before this event, and I'm still kind of shaking off the 100% rust. Jump is kind of hard to make. Ah. Oh, I got it. Well, that was lucky. I'm supposed to jump into the water with the jiggy in my hands, but I failed it and then somehow got it. So we'll just take that. So this pattern is the same every time. You're supposed to follow him, but you don't have to. It's just memory, memorization.
We have $5 from Anonymous. Stiv, it's 5 o'clock in the morning. Why on earth are you playing Banjo-Kazooie?
Because I've lost control of my life. No, why did I do that? Oh my god, that was dumb. That was just a input slip up.
Mm-hmm.
I got it at least. So we're just finishing up the level here, getting the rest of the collectibles. Missed the Mumble token earlier, so I have to make up for it with this one. I didn't open the gate that would allow me to get into the area I need to go to, so I'm just going to do a quick little bypass. Alright, so that reset was intentional. As bad as the run is, I have to keep going. So, it's faster to do reset and get a jiggy earlier on in the lair instead of backtracking for it later and detransforming from a pumpkin. Clanker's Cavern Witch Switch. Jiggy. If I didn't get it now, I would get it before Click Clock Wood later on. Uh-huh. So Freeze Easy Peak is one of my favorite levels, personally. It's got some pretty neat stuff in it. You'll see, I guess. Go explain as I go along. Alright, so this right here, you're supposed to fight those green guys and save the lights and let them pass and get to the tree. But if you just kill the first one and then go in this box so that the green guys are out of view, it keeps them from loading, and that allows the lights to just have a clear path without having to do anything.
We have $15 from Tyronic, donating because I love watching my boy speedrun my favorite game.
It's a lot, Tyronic. So this trick here is called the YOLO Star. We're supposed to fly through that three times, but instead we just do that. Feathers should be enough. So I'm skipping these notes. I'm going to come back to them later. As a troll. To this. I hope I can get this. Alright. Race. I'm going to try to get a bunch of collectibles during the race and still win. It's kind of tight. Hopefully I get it. Yeah.
Welcome.
If you fall too far behind, you automatically lose. So that's why it's scary. Purposely letting him get ahead. Taking advantage of the rubber banding. No. Looks close, but it's not. One of the only text boxes you can't skip. Not sure why, but... Zooming in the camera for lag reduction. I need 5 HP, so I'm just gonna get one of these. Hey! Yeah, that race is a little tighter, but it works out. So you're supposed to go into this hole as a walrus. It's the intended way, but by doing a little quick dive trick, by taking damage, you can access it as Banjo. And then you grab this and die. Grab these feathers just to be safe. So now this part is a little scary. I gotta grab a couple chickens without landing. This chicken in particular is scary. If I did land, then I would have to go back and reset the flight pad, and it would waste close to a minute. So yeah, as you may have noticed, just beak bombing into walls where jiggies lie behind lets you grab them. So now we're heading into Rusty Bucket Bay. Rusty Bucket Bay is one of the harder levels. It's very easy to die in, especially in the engine room, which you'll see. Because if you fall, you're dead, and that wastes a good minute or so. But at least it's in the beginning of the run, so it could be worse. Thank you. you're supposed to slow down those fans by hitting a switch elsewhere in the level, but as you can see, I can just run right through them. It is dangerous though, because as you jump through them, they can clip you and send you on an angle that makes you fall. So it's a very scary part of the game. Okay. That was a clip. It works because couldn't tell you. So yeah, in this level the water takes extra double air. So that's dangerous. Trying to do a trick called zip climbing. Yeah, so it gives you extra distance on your climb if you do a ground pound, if you time it correctly, but most of the time I don't think it's worth doing. There it might be, but I don't bother with it usually. So there, you're supposed to fight him, obviously, but if you shoot eggs at him before you trigger the cutscene, then the whole thing is just omitted. So that's scary, but we did it. Yeah, I thought that was gonna happen. If you time it correctly, you can get up there without leaving Talentrot, but I messed up. Okay, now this. Go away. Do a jump here. Hopefully I don't mess it up. Okay. I kind of took that save. Come, come. You can learn that code, it's somewhere in the level on the boat. Just memorize it. They're doing the damage boost. I'm just gonna take it safe. Jump onto a jiggy out of water, then you just pick it up and you don't have to watch the dance animation. I waited a little longer there for the buoy because I wanted it to be at a good angle. Otherwise, I would have missed the jiggy. Just gonna take some damage here. For that level. Now we're gonna head into the final level. Click Clock Wood, my personal favorite. There's some clips in Click Clock Wood, but for the most part it's just movement, and it's very unforgiving. You have to climb a tree, and you're very high up, and if you fall, and depending on how high up you are, you still waste a lot of time, even if you're not that high, but... Point is, you don't want to fall. Ha 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 ha! This jump is finicky. There we go. I can't see. Alright, so now I just have to backtrack a little bit and open the level. This is where that cauldron comes in. Okay, so my egg count is actually really good now. I overcompensated. But that's never a problem. Here I'm going to do a clip to go out of bounds and get back to the start of the level. There. Oh, almost had it. Should work. Yep. It's faster if you do it fast. That wasn't particularly fast. Now you have to feed Eerie the bird in summer and fall.
Okay.
Actually, RNG how fast the bees approach you. You can tell, because if you use only three feathers, that means they approached you pretty quickly. But I used four there, which is average. Oh, that's not good. Tricky, that's tricky. The game's kind of lagging. So sometimes you miss your input. So I'm at a pretty dangerous amount of health. One hit from those birds will kill me, so I really need to be careful. I don't want to waste gold feathers. Wow, this worm is really far out there. It's usually not that far back. This is really risky. I usually go for that quicker. Leap of faith, okay. Part two. Okay. Part three. Okay. You know what? Let's just get the health. At this point, it's just worth it. Keep on, keep on. You don't want to die, you especially don't want to die in Click Clock Wood. Now in autumn, you need 10 worms. Just coming in here for notes. You can't transport me to anything. Oh, Usually I would get this in winter, but it's safer to get it in fall, and it's really not that much faster to get it in winter, honestly. It's a lot safer to get it in fall. Okay, so you notice the camel is there in autumn. You're supposed to water the plant again to make the flower bloom, but we're gonna skip that, and you'll see why. Need to collect some nuts for my squirrel friend. It's pretty good.
Come.
Winter is just a lot of flying, and there's a couple of pretty cool clips at the end. Oh. Where am I? Okay. Fully grown, and he's gonna leave us a present for our efforts. Man, my angle was trash. Almost salvaged it. Man, I screwed up. That's okay. I'll just take a detour. Not supposed to lose fight there. I might as well go for this now. Not going to jump that. I am going to kill you. Jiggy, but you know what? I'll just get it. Spring. Here's the clip. Grab this. Or land. And not show you the clip. That's okay too, I guess. But I'll just do the backup strat. Not quite as cool. Okay. I'm gonna go back to spring now. So in this part, I'm gonna show you why I didn't hit the camel in autumn. I'll explain the glitch after it's done. That probably looked really confusing. It was blind. And how that works is, so you're allowed to, well, you're not supposed to be able to, but you can poop eggs into the flower to make it bloom. But since you're not supposed to do that, the game kind of freaks out and softlocks. And you just have to kind of memorize how to maneuver yourself to get to Mumbo's skull without being able to see. It's not as hard as it looks, but it's definitely intimidating. And wait a minute, I'm forgetting something. Almost forgot. Where is it? There it is. So I was supposed to get that in winter, but I lost my flight, and yeah, bad things happened. Didn't feel like wasting feathers to get it. But in hindsight, I probably should have. And that's not supposed to happen. And you just do a quick little clip to get out of there. So for this part, I'm actually going to use something called the Furnace Fun Calculator, which minimizes the RNG that Furnace Fun presents. It's much better to use, especially in a marathon setting. Don't really feel like getting screwed over by RNG. So how it works is you input whether an answer is incorrect or correct, and then it calculates which answer to a specific question is more likely or unlikely. So, the reason I need to do this is for the specific questions about Grunty, the answers change with every save file, so I don't know the answers, and I didn't learn them throughout the run. Properly. So if I get this square wrong, I die, and that's really bad. Answering these without listening to them because the question, the answer choices are the same, so it's easy to memorize them. Cool, that was pretty lucky. Furnace first one's hit. So instead of finishing the board and watching the fake credits, you can just bypass the rest of all of that and save like 8 to 10 minutes by getting a death square wrong and then being thrown into the lava, supposedly, but accidentally back on the board. And then you just go straight to the fight, and this is the last section of the run. Should be good on feathers.
Yeah.
Plenty. Alright, that usually doesn't hit. So I positioned myself in a way that I could poop the eggs into the statue as they were rising, and this skips. These shots are pretty tricky. I honestly should be better at them. Time is going to be when I activate the Ginginator. About 30 seconds or so, I'll say time. Alright, not too bad. Not too bad. Alright, well, I can definitely do better than that, but that was pretty good for a marathon run, considering I made a huge mistake in the beginning of the run. So, sub-210 is still good for all that. Yeah, that's about it. I hope you all enjoyed it.
Thank you, StivityBobo, for a great Banjo-Kazooie 100% run.